So now we're all heading to the Museum of Tropical Queensland. Okay, so this is the HMS Pandora, which has sunk, losing many lives just off the coast of Townsville. Even the floorboard or the carpet on the floor is laid out in the actual size that the ship is. And you can see where the cannons would be, the planks. And this is a cut-out relief of the ship. And at this stage, I haven't quite worked out what these are in relationship to. This signifies our ships, and the little snippet you saw was about the ports of Townsville, and everything was done by muscle power. Now, soldier represents the important role the armed services have played in the local area and international conflicts. And this lady represents our pioneer farmers. Our pioneer farmers represent our rural roots and how our ancestors toiled to create futures for their families. And this, of course, is our marine scientists. They represent the pool of talented researchers who are based in North Queensland. This is the HMS Pandora on her last voyage. And here we have India trying out the leg irons. The captured mutineers were imprisoned in a special wooden cell built by the ship's carpenters on the quarterdeck. And here they could be guarded effectively and kept apart for the rest of the crew. The prisoners named their cell Pandora's Box.
What happened? Yeah.
That's a true story.
So what's happening is that there's water coming on board.
The ship's going down and the men are trying to escape from below deck where they've been imprisoned.
But the sea we saw through the stern ports.
And this is the area known as the mine zone, and it's for children to open their minds and discover things. Get in there, Jake. This is a red mangroves mock-up scene in the Tropical Museum. And then we go down below the mangroves under the water to see the fish. And finally we've made it to the tropical rainforest area. An incredible little area that's been built in here. So what have we got there? A python.
A carpet python.
A carpet python.
Yep.
A Lloyd's dragon. It's a rufous owl with a possum that he's having for dinner. And of course the old satin bowerbird.